Good evening and welcome to another oil change video. This time I will be working on this Mercedes M111 engine which rattles if sitting for more than 5 days or so. Let's listen. The cause of this is most likely oil starvation of the hydraulic lifters. It only takes a few seconds for oil to reach them, but the noise is still a bit unsettling. I will try to rectify this with a simple oil change. It is a bit thicker than what I normally use and actually not approved by Daimler to be used on this engine. Actually, nobody approves this oil. Its sister products, however, all carry the necessary approvals, so I'll go ahead and use it anyway. The second property of this oil is addition of liquified molybdenum disulfide, or simply Moly, spelled with one L. Now you know where the company's name came from. Along the job, of course, also comes a filter change. Neither of these products were sponsored in any way. First, I'm going to remove the belly pan. There are two bolts holding it in the front and two more in the back, one on each side. Take 8mm socket and remove all of them. When all of the bolts are removed, just swiggle the belly pan slightly backwards and it will fall off. Slide it out of the way and put aside. And when I zoom in, you can see the oil drain bolt. To get to the oil filter, first we remove this plastic cover. Just grab it firmly and tug it out of its place. The filter is hiding behind this cap. To remove the oil filter cap, you need a special 76mm 14-flute wrench tool. Trying to remove the cap without this tool is a pain in the butt and prone to damaging something. I strongly advise you to invest in it if you are performing this job by yourself. But with proper tools, all of this is super easy. Time to place the canister below the car and undo the drain plug. It takes a 14mm socket. Obviously, I would recommend to raise the car, but to demonstrate how easy this job is, I'm actually performing it while the car is on the ground. Now let the oil drain, and in the meantime, we can clean the plug. The gasket will need to be replaced, and it seems that somebody used silicone of some sort, which shouldn't be necessary. Some plugs do come with a rubber gasket, but this is not it. Once finally nice and clean, let's place a new gasket on it. And now we're gonna focus on the filter. First, remove the old O-ring on the cap, lubricate the new one with some oil, and slide it into the groove in the cap. Then, fit in the oil filter. It has to click, as it only goes in one way. Put the cap with the filter back, thread it in by hand, and then torque it to 25 Nm. Pretty much the same applies to the drain plug. This engine takes 5.5 liters of oil. After the first big canister is empty, let's check the level. Almost full, I'll add the remaining after a short engine run. Now the level is right in the middle, so I just need to add 500 milliliters as expected. The rest goes in the trunk. I would reset the oil service interval on the instrument cluster, however, it doesn't work anymore on this car. But why not place the label? The next oil change should be about 250,000 kilometers or after 1 year. I usually drive for a few days without the belly pan so I can inspect if there are any leaks. Luckily, there weren't any. I was out for a few weeks while the car sat quietly in the garage. Time to find out if this oil had any impact on the startup rattle. No way! It actually worked! I cannot say if it is due to viscosity or due to the molybdenum additive, or maybe a combination of both, but I'm happy with the result either way, and we'll probably use this oil again.